What's up guys, it's Tom here and welcome to a brand new Liverpool news update video, and we will talk about Xabi Alonso because the big Welt newspaper, which means the world newspaper in German, they think and they report that Liverpool see Xabi Alonso as the perfect man to replace Jurgen Klopp, and we are already in talks with Bayer Leverkusen over appointing Xabi Alonso in the summer. After Jurgen Klopp's departure, a fee has not been agreed yet, and it will have to be in the double-digit millions for Leverkusen to agree to let Xabi Alonso leave, which means that it could be 10-12 million euros to buy Xabi Alonso out of his contract, because he still has 1 year left on his contract at Leverkusen. But Bayer Leverkusen told the newspaper that if a good offer arrived from... Bayer Leverkusen told Xabi Alonso that if a good offer arrived from one of his former clubs, they will let him leave, because they have a gentleman's agreement with Xabi Alonso that if he wants to leave for a really big club, is one of his former clubs, Bayern Munich, Real Madrid or Liverpool, then he could leave Leverkusen even before his contract expires. The big question is that gentleman's agreement about Xabi Alonso leaving for free, or is it that Leverkusen want a compensation for the remainder of Xabi Alonso's contract? Do you see Liverpool paying like 8 million pounds, which could be around 11 million euros, for appointing Xabi Alonso? I think he would be worth it because he's the best candidate, in my opinion. He knows the club the most out of all the like top managers in world football right now, and it wouldn't be a crazy like 50 million pound transfer or something like that. So if it's 10 million euros, that's like 7 or 8 million pounds. That wouldn't be too much of a hurdle. Today's other headline that we will talk about in the second part of the video is David Ornstein confirmed that some of the top players at Liverpool, like Virgil van Dijk, Mo Salah, Trent Alexander-Arnold, they were very unhappy, or not very unhappy, but unhappy about Liverpool not informing them of Jurgen Klopp quitting the club at the end of the season before the announcement was made. The players basically knew just a few minutes before the whole public knew that Jurgen Klopp is stepping down, because Liverpool filmed that video of Jurgen Klopp announcing that he's leaving Liverpool at the end of the season, when really nobody was at the training ground. Liverpool players probably had an off day, so the Liverpool players didn't know in advance. They knew they got to know the fact that Jurgen Klopp is leaving the same day as the club announced it, and some of the top players are unhappy. And Virgil van Dijk, Salah and Trent Alexander-Arnold only has 1 year left on their contracts, so we will talk about that, all that, in the second part of the video. If you enjoy these update videos about Liverpool Football Club, make sure to leave a like, subscribe if you are new around here, and you can further support me by clicking my Patreon link in the video's description, where you can donate and you get additional benefits, more content your way, and it also helps me continue making these videos. Thank you so much for your awesome support. And the German media is already linking Florian Wirtz to Liverpool if Xabi Alonso becomes the next manager of Liverpool Football Club. Apparently, according to the newspapers, he's keen on bringing this young star, Florian Wirtz, who is from the Leverkusen Youth Academy, to Anfield, and a potential 75 million euro deal, which could be around 60 million pounds, underscores the ambitious blueprint Xabi Alonso has for Liverpool. And that could be a big, big major signing, but I think we need a centre-back more than attacking midfielder. We already have Dominic Soboslay, Curtis Jones, who are scoring goals from the midfield, and we also have Alexis McAllister scoring goals, maybe a defensive midfielder, or Endo playing and in the defensive midfield role, and McAllister playing further forward. Could see McAllister adding even more goals to his already very, very good season. John Barnes, the Liverpool legend, the Liverpool winger of the 90s, has said that he is in favor of Xabi Alonso becoming a Liverpool manager, highlighting his understanding of Liverpool's ethos. And of course, he had a great success being manager at Leverkusen. And Xabi Alonso would be the ideal candidate because he represents a bridge between Liverpool's past and hopefully very successful and definitely very ambitious future of Liverpool Football Club. Of course, it would be a huge challenge coming in after Jurgen Klopp, but Xabi Alonso also has the charisma, the personality needed to be the next manager of Liverpool. Because Jamie Carragher highlights that the manager is the most important person at a football club in England, and especially at Liverpool, because after Bill Shankly, Bob Paisley and Jurgen Klopp and Kenny Dalglish, Liverpool have a long line of iconic managers with great personality, great sense of humor, great charisma. They are always having a very, very important connection with the fans. And if the manager doesn't have that charisma and doesn't have that connection with the fans, it's a problem at Liverpool, because at Liverpool, the manager, alongside the fans, is the most important connection with the football club. And the manager connects the fans to the football club in a way. I think in the modern game, Jamie Carragher said, now you need alignment right through a club. And if you bring a manager in and a director of football in, whose ideas on the game, the players they bring in, and how a team should play are different, it's not going to work. So if the manager and the sporting director, their vision doesn't align, then it's going to be cause tension. It is going to cause problems. What you have to try and do is bring people together who have a similar sort of footballing idea. So that's why Liverpool should search for the manager alongside searching for the sporting director. Jamie Carragher continued, for me, the most important person at the football club is the manager. So most important thing for Liverpool is to do is to get the right manager involved and make sure they get the backroom staff for the manager, the backroom staff he wants, because the whole backroom team of Jurgen Klopp are moving on. They need to get Jurgen Klopp's replacement right and spot on. And that being said, the scouting structure and the whole management structure at Liverpool is still very strong, and the guy at the top, who is the director of football, Liverpool haven't got that, and that person will have to have similar sort of ideas, similar sort of vision to the manager that they get. So I think this should go hand in hand, getting a brilliant sporting director and a fantastic manager as well. And Liverpool probably brought in Jörg Schmatke as a like short-term solution, as a temporary sporting director, because they knew that sooner or later Jurgen Klopp will leave and they would need to appoint a different sporting director. And also there wasn't like an obvious standout candidate. West Ham's sporting director is heavily linked with Liverpool and others as well. And why it's crucial that Liverpool appoint the right kind of manager and sporting director is because the big stars, David Ornstein confirmed, Virgil van Dijk, Mo Salah and Trent Alexander-Arnold, they won't want to commit their futures to Liverpool until they know who is going to be in charge and what his vision is for Liverpool's future and what his vision is for these stars. So then the new manager, they need to speak with the new manager and see whether they have the plans in place to make Liverpool or continue Liverpool making them successful, and also what kind of role they see Virgil van Dijk having in a squad. Because if the new manager comes in and says, Virgil van Dijk, you won't be a regular starter for me anymore, I can't promise you game time, then Virgil van Dijk would look to move on. I'm just saying that as a hypothetical scenario. If the new manager says he will play a different role, Trent Alexander-Arnold, and maybe just be a regular right back, maybe Trent would want to move on. I hope not. He's a Scouser, he's a Liverpool legend, he's Liverpool through and through. He's like the next Steven Gerrard for me, Trent Alexander-Arnold, in terms of what he represents for Liverpool Football Club, and he should stay at Liverpool for the rest of his career. But he would want to see what the new manager thinks, what his role should be in the team. And these are very delicate situations, very delicate questions. And the fact that Liverpool let these contracts run down suggests to me that maybe even in the summer there were discussions about Jurgen Klopp maybe having one more season. Pep Inders recently gave a brilliant interview about his time at Liverpool and why he decided to leave. He already had this plan that if Jurgen Klopp leaves, Pep Inders will leave with him as well. And it's understandable, because a new manager would want his new backroom staff with him as well. his own backroom staff with him as well, and Pep Inders would want to try out himself in management, in full senior management. He wants to be a manager full-time of a football club, not just an assistant manager. So I think I will follow Pep Inders' career very carefully. David Ornstein also said that some of the Liverpool stars were unhappy about not being told in advance of Jurgen Klopp leaving the football club. And I kind of understand that, but also it's a double-edged sword. It's like, damned if you do, damned if you know, don't. Because if Jurgen Klopp and Liverpool tells these players in November that he's leaving, surely the players sooner or later will tell their families, their friends about it. And it just takes one guy or one woman to leak the story to a major newspaper in England for some cash, or even just, you know, to mention it in a friendly setting. Sooner or later it would leak out. And then Jurgen Klopp and Liverpool would not be in control of that situation. And it would spread like wildfire. And imagine if there was a rumor that Jurgen Klopp is quitting Liverpool while he still has another 2 years left on his contract. It would have been an absolute PR disaster for Liverpool Football Club and for Jurgen Klopp. So I think, ultimately, Jurgen Klopp had to choose this scenario. Not to tell anyone but the owners and maybe the very, very closest backroom staff. Some of the wider backroom staff at Liverpool didn't know that Jurgen Klopp is leaving. He just told probably the closest people to him and the Liverpool owners. And that's it. That's why it didn't leak to the press, and that's why I think ultimately it was the right decision, even if it upset some of the stars at Liverpool. But I don't think that's why they could leave Liverpool. It will be either because the new manager wants different roles for them, or because they see Liverpool not maybe giving them the big contracts that they are looking for. Virgil van Dijk will be 33 years old in the summer, and he would want to have one last big contract. And I really hope that Liverpool will keep all of them, because without Salah, without van Dijk, the new manager will have an even more difficult job to keep this success story of Liverpool going. The good news is that there is a report in the English news outlet Football Insider that the Liverpool board will push to keep Mo Salah at the club this summer, even though there is a big upheaval at Anfield, big changes coming. Saudi clubs retain what sources says is a concrete interest in Mo Salah, and they will return with more offers in the summer transfer window as they look to get a deal for Salah over the line. But Liverpool's stance is they do not want to lose the man many consider Liverpool's best player at the same time as their manager. And that's the thing, Liverpool don't want to lose any more key personnel at Liverpool. Imagine if we lose Jurgen Klopp and the whole backroom staff and the sporting director. If we lose Salah or Van Dijk or Trent Alexander-Arnold or any other big players as well, it would make the rebuilding job for the new manager even harder, even more difficult. So there is a lot of uncertainty at Liverpool right now, but I just wanted to give you guys some new information about what is going on, and hopefully we will get some good news sooner rather than later of Liverpool announcing who the new manager will be. I really hope it will be Xabi Alonso. I think he's the best candidate, but whoever it will be, he will have one hell of a job on his hands. But Liverpool are in the right place. We have a fantastic squad of players, and if we can keep like 95% of this squad together for next season, that would be very, very good. But I think, and Virgil van Dijk confirmed this in a recent interview, that they are very happy at Liverpool right now. They don't want to leave. They just want to see what's next. And I think it's personally very understandable, because when big changes are coming at the football club, you always want to see what the plans are for the next manager, what kind of playing style he would want, who he wants at the football club. And also, what kind of contracts will Liverpool offer them? And I think FSG have a big job on their hands. They need to give these guys big contracts, and they also need to give the manager big funds in the summer transfer window. And with murmurings coming from Boston that FSG are not supporting the Boston Red Sox financially, they are not spending any money, and they are losing players as well. So I really hope that at Liverpool that won't be the case. Also, a journalist confirmed that Liverpool are seriously putting effort into future prospects, future talent, and talent development. The increase in scouting and development throughout England, but also it has been heavily Irish focused in the past season. Ireland and Northern Ireland are providing some really good talents, and Liverpool look to benefit on it. Conor Bradley is from Northern Ireland, and Trent Cone-Doherty also is another talent on Liverpool's books, and we are looking maybe to get more talented players in this way, so that's very encouraging news as well. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, have a lovely day, see you later guys, goodbye.